Hey everyone, Angry Ice Cube here, and today we are in the Fens of Nathsar. This here is the Kai Long zone in right here. And here's the first thing you see, a bunch of XR just standing here going, hey, what's up with Assistant Ville. The first thing they're going to do is give you a quest to do something. I don't remember what the quest was actually, but she'll give you a quest. Well, actually, why don't we just ask her? What's the
quest? Met.
Alright, knows the unfreaking greeting, blah blah blah, blah blah blah. Rightful masters, you're an outsider, you suck, blah blah blah. Okay. Something I can do to earn your trust. Alright. Okay, what do I do? Alright. Oh, that's right, I gotta gather the items that she needs. Alright, let's see what we got here. Gives you 1,000 fashion with Rillus, so Rillus won't eat your face. Ooh, I got some collections to turn in. There we are. Excuse me. We have 5 feathers, 5 pelts, and 5 other pelts. Alright, so we need Tusker Hide, Sabertooth Pelts, and Stonebeak Down. Now, you gotta be careful when you come into Fens of Nathsar because, I don't see them, but oh, there they are. Those guys will be hostile. They're, as you can see, they're only level 70, but there's 2 of them, and they do ride back and forth patrolling the road, and if they see you, they'll attack you if you don't do the quest to get the faction up. Let's see what else we have here. We have a Soka Car Post. Let's take a quick look at the Soka Car Post and see what we have available. Alright, so here we are at the Kai Long Post. Then there's the Bathazid's Watch Post. Sethir's Span, Eastern Pins, Western Pins, Omen's Calls, Rillus, Enter a Troops Laboratory, that's the Shard Zone. Drogon Exiles, Capolis, Belly Wumper, and Dragon's Rest. I can see it's a pretty big zone. This is the Field of Bone right here. Remember Jaled Dar and his bones where he, you know, kicked the Sethirian Empire's ass? Yeah, he's right there. That's also the site of the new public quest involving him. Yeah, not much to say about that. These guys are the Riders of Ick. They're kind of icky, I guess you could say. Yeah, all right, here we go. We got some Sarnak here. That's Bathazid's Watch. They're down this road this way. They are also hostile to you. They are also where you go to get your crafting epic at level 80. It's a quest called the Proof of the Pudding. You gotta get your faction up with them, obviously, because, you know, if you're gonna be doing crafting there, you don't want them to be stabbing you in the ass with the spear. But here's the Tuskers, and here's the Stonebeaks, and Sabertooths are over here somewhere. We don't actually care about them right now because, as you can see, I don't really need to worry about good faction. Why? Because I'm hardcore. Alright, well, what the heck. You know what? Let's go show you Bathazid's Watch. Like I said, you just go along this cliffside road and it'll take you up and around there, but we'll fly over there and take a look. Rillus is the Ixar town in this area, so the Span is the Ixar outpost. It's a bridge with tents on it, so I mean it's kind of like a tribal village, I guess, on a big bridge. But Rillus is the main city over here. It's also where you'll find Dominus Ryle, Rillus Ryle. He was one of the 4 fathers or sons of Veneral. Remember him? Yeah. He's in one of the buildings, so you want to be careful before you just go running willy-nilly in, because he might be up, and he might kick you in the face. He did that to me once. I've never forgiven him for it. Also, before I get too into this video, I want to apologize if anyone has been leaving comments. Now, you'll know I'm always making little snide comments about how no one ever leaves comments. Well, last night, someone left a comment, and for once, YouTube notified me that I had a comment. And I said, okay, so I went over, and it was someone I play on here with, and I, you know, answered him. But when I went to the comments page, I noticed something very interesting. 4 videos, all of which are marked 0 comments, had comments. And have had comments for several months. However, since they're marked as 0 comments, I had no reason to go check out the comments page, and so I've been ignoring them. So if you ever leave me a comment and I don't respond, maybe send me a message or something, because chances are, if I don't respond, well, there's 2 possibilities. One is a spam message and I'm not going to pay any attention to it, or 2, I didn't see it. And there's a couple on there. Yeah, it's like I recognized one of them. I saw it a long time ago, and I tried to respond to it, but it told me that there was no comment to respond to, and it wouldn't let me. But it's still there. The video is still marked as 0 comments, and someone, or that same person, left a comment on a later video. And again, that video is also marked zero comments, but there it is. And I was like, thank you, YouTube. That really makes me happy. YouTube used to send me notifications when I got comments. It doesn't do it anymore. It only sends me notifications when I get a actual direct message. So, yeah, I don't know what's going on there. Bath's Watch. So, that building over there is where the crafting area is. As you can see, there are quests over here. These guys are hostile, like everyone in this. This whole zone's hostile, too. You got to make them like you. These guys will eat your face, but you can kill, I believe it's the goblins down there, I think. It's been a long time since I've actually killed mobs for faction, but I believe the goblins will give you faction for these guys. And then there's some non-Bathazid Sarnak that will give you Rillus faction, and there are also the Froglocks, the Reet Slaves. I can't remember who you killed to get faction with them, but they're out here too. But yeah, crafting. You got a little green feather there. Again, you need to get your faction up, because if you don't have your faction up, you can't buy the fuels and stuff. And I don't know if you'll be able to do the work requisitions, and I can't remember. Anyways, you have to get your faction up so you can buy the fuels at least. Otherwise, you're going to be doing a lot of running back and forth. Ooh, that'll be fun. But yeah, that's where you get your crafting epic. It's called the proof of the pudding or something like that. And what you have to do is you have to craft stuff. Surprise, surprise. It depends on what class you are for a crafter. What it will do is give you a certain item that you need to make, but you actually have to make all of them, but you need to find other crafters to commission their items so you can turn them into the final person who gives you the earring. Where is it? Good question, where is it? I'm not wearing it, am I? Am I wearing it? No. Where is it? I know she has it. She's one of my primary crafters. This is actually the guild leader here. I don't see the earring. Oh, there it is. Earring of the Solstice. So you get your 61 stamina. Ooh, it's got the plus 25 to all the gathering abilities. That's important. And it lets you see the red shinies, which are the trade skill shinies. So, yeah. Anyhow, enough of Bathazid's Watch. Let's move on to Sathir's Span. Sathir's Span, as in Veneral Sathir. While you're down there, you might want to, while you're in the zone, you might want to look for all those pages so you can complete the green and black tomes, because apparently those are necessary to do the stuff to get into the latest expansion, Kunark Ascending. Or so I was told. I don't know if it's true or not, but someone told me that you need to have done the black and green tomes. So, and those are both in this zone, and both of the NPCs you need are in this zone. One of them is, the black tome is in Sathir's Span, and the green tome is one of these guys. This guy? Yeah, Jerome and Shorty. Shorty is particularly obnoxious. This is the green tome dude, and then there's a guy right here. Yeah, that's him, Seth the Sky. He's the black tome dude. They will each teach you a language, if you have collected all the pages. The pages are scattered all over the place out here. Yeah. All right. One of the public quests is up. That's when you see people screaming stuff about something is up. It's generally a public quest. Like, for example, we have the Fens of Nathsar, which is with Jaled Dar's Shade. And then we have the Jarsath Wastes, which is the Ixar Hero statue, which I'm assuming, I haven't actually done that PQ. I watched it, but I didn't actually do it. The Ixar Hero is a gigantic Ixar statue, which for some reason attacks the battlement that Danik's Legion have. So it's like, I'm assuming that the Droag have taken it over or something. I don't know. But yeah, there's Seth this guy right there. He's the guy with the black tome. You can safely run along the road for the most part. Just, again, watch these guys if you don't have faction, because they will attack you. They will attack the mobs that get too close in the road as well, so they actually do act as actual patrolling guards, so that's nice. But yeah, this is Sathir's Span. Behold the glory. Yeah. Also, down there. Okay, you see that little rock right there? That's the Tomb of Fuga. That's one of the tier 1 raid mobs for Rise of Kunark. That's where you'll find Tyreza, the Web Mistress or Widow Mistress or whatever the hell her name was. Anyway, she's a Drachnid. It's a raid zone. Not too terribly difficult. In fact, it's probably the easiest of the tier 1s. Yeah, that's about all there is to say about that. You can jump down there. It's safe because it's, you know, water and stuff, but yeah. And if you do, you have to get back up through an elevator right over there. See that little thing there? Yeah, elevator there. Let's see what else can I say about this zone. Well, let's go this way. Head over to the swamp of no hope, which is over here. If you're a swashbuckler, you're going to run all through this place on your epic quest because you're reenacting the Princess Bride, and this is the this is the swamp. Remember when they had to run away from Prince Humperdinck? Yeah, this is the swamp you go in here, and they even have wyverns of unusual size. They're in here too. I like the swashbuckler record. I did not much care for the fight at the end because, holy crap, back in the day when that was like new, holy mama, that pirate dude was an asshole. All right, that's all I'm gonna say. But I managed to scrape by, barely. All right, so we're running through here. There's a swamp. You're gonna find reet slaves and all sorts of stuff out here. It's much worse on the other side of this ridge. This is the river right here. Oh, by the way, this takes you to the Kunzar jungle. There's two zones in Kunzar. There's this one right here, which is over by Rillus, and then there's this one right here, which is down at the bottom of this gorge. The one at the bottom of the gorge takes you over to the side I mentioned where the Rhyme Fortress, or not Fortress, the Rhyme Forces have gathered. Yeah. Down there by Sebalus. Isn't that neat? Alright, so let's see. If you are over here, you'll notice some pages on the map. These are one of the two books. Shuffled page. Is that black or green? That's green. Okay, so shuffled is green and loose, I think, is black. Loose, there's some pages over here, I know. There's one. Loose page 5, so yeah. Alright, so that's a neat little place. I don't remember it being overgrown like this before. Might have been something they added, or it might have been from my little factory reset. Although I don't think so. Good at it. I don't know, it's been years since I've been in the zone, so. I mean, I usually pop in real quick while I'm on my way someplace else, but I don't really scout the place out, so, yeah. So behold, there is now vegetation. It used to just be a lake down there. There's probably still just a lake down there. The warlock has to go down there for their epic. I remember that much. I probably need to work on my warlock's epic, but yeah. Yeah, here we go. Krupp Knights. These are part of the Reet people. Oh, there's that guy. Yeah, he's named. Wyvern. Actually, no, he's a Soko card, not a Wyvern. Well, whatever. So he's a dragon frog. As I recall, the Soko card, part dragon, part frog. Because that a tree, man, he likes to mess around. He's like, what would happen if you crossed a gnoll and a goat? You get Kiko. Oh, snap. Where are you now, Kiko? Yeah, that's right. You're not here to defend yourself, so I can say whatever I want about you. Yeah, anyhow. Where were we? Oh, yes, we're running through this little swampy place. So this is what this swampy side looks like. Okay, we just got some stuff over here. Like I said, there are some pages over here that you'll find for the green tome. And there is all... Oh! The Mystic Epic Mob, the Spirit Racked Soko Car. I think it's a Soko Car. Spirit Racked something is over here as well. A guild called Tower of Hate. That's an interesting name for a guild. Oh well. I suppose it could be worse. Alright, here's... Ah, there it is. Yeah, Soko Car. You need these guys for the Mystic Epic. It's been so long since I did my Mystic's Epic that I don't actually remember what you do with them. Do you just fight them, or do you have to cast a spell on them or something like that? But anyways, he's over here. And over here is where you'll find a couple pages. Actually, there's a page up by one of those Treant dudes, Swamp Ants, whatever. There it is. Let's go take a look. No, that's not it. That's a geode. This is a stone node. call it stone node because you can get metals and gems off of it, and I therefore distinguish it between regular ore nodes and stone nodes. Here's shuffle page. There it is. Oh, I was going to pick it up. I don't think I need it, though. No, I don't need it. Take it, though, because I can always put it in the bank and get a one-up on it. Alright. And then we have the shinies. Yay for the shinies. Even though they're sparkly, it's more than shiny. Whatever. Great earring. Hey, is that the rare one? Well, if it is, I don't need it, obviously, but... And like I said, here's the zone into Kunzar. It's down at the bottom of the gorge here. This is the Swamp of No Hope. It's down there. You go down that way and it'll zone in. Alright, so since we've done that... Oh, again, there's another page like right over here at the end of it as well. Actually, I think there's two pages over here. Three if you count the one I just picked up. In fact, with both of those quests, as I recall, it's... You'll find half of the quest in one area, and then half of the quest in the other area. Or collections, I should say. Whatever. Alright, where were I? Where was I? Where something? I don't even know how to talk. Oh, right. We were going to go up to Rillus and check it out. But first, we found another page. So we'll collect it, because why not? Now I can get a 2-up. Don't know who I'll get that 2-up with, but someone will get it. Bathazid Subverters. I remember them. I believe there was a quest I had to kill them at one point. It's kind of tricky to do all the quests in here because, you know, if you don't want to hurt your faction, then you gotta time them right. Or you can just say, I don't give a damn, and do it anyways. You can always work the factions back up later. As long as you're over 40k, you're fine. That's allied status. You don't need to be at 50k. Yeah, the flaming logs. Yeah, you had to chop these for the swashbuckler epic. And something would attack you. Or maybe something would attack you. Or maybe I was just getting attacked by ads. I don't remember. Anyhow, we're going this way. Having a good time. There's a Rillusian slaver. Because, you know, Ixar are assholes. You know, you think having been slaves for hundreds of years themselves, they wouldn't want to subject anyone else to it. But no. That's the whole thing about being an asshole. It's like, hey, you know, everyone's been a total douche to me, so I'm going to break free of that, and then I can do it right back. Yay! I can understand going back at the people to attack. Well, the Ixar can't, though, because the I can't remember what their name are. The snake people. Shisar, there we go. The Shisar are gone, so they can't really strike back now, can they? But that's no excuse. There's a croc. No Hope Needletails, Sokol Cars, all sorts of stuff out here. And if we go past these crystal growths, this is where you're going to find some quatches. Remember the quatches are like Yeti dudes? Yeah, they're up here. If you go past these crystal growths, either side of the crystal growths, you go past them. Rillus is on the other side of this mountain right here. There's a road over there, and there's a little path right here. You can see something Rillus related right there. Behold, the crystal grove. You got some Sokol Car pins. They have an Air Force. Rillusian Air Force. They ride Sokol Car. This is a regular page, but I'm still picking it up. Orphis and Kirkata. I don't remember. I forgot about him. Yeah, when they added the rhyme, they added the these lords. As you can see, they're epics. And they would ride back and forth. And this guy used to be a complete and total asshole because he rides back and forth along this road. And when you're not expecting him, that's quite a shock. Especially when you're like, you know, level 74. But they're not that tough anymore. If you go into the Ascent of Rhyme, remember that place in the Great Divide? You get to fight the Southern Lord and the something else Lord. Eastern, I think? As the Northern Lord and I believe the Western Lord are the ones that you'll find in here. There's also the Western Lord is in Kunzar. That road down there, by the way, leads to Kunzar. So let's go up to the top here because this is Rillus. It's a great place. Check it out. Apparently the raid is going on, the public quest raid. So, you know what? Let's go check it out while it's up. If it is up. I'm assuming it is because people are shouting about it, but then again, people could just be assuming that it's up and shouting about something that's not here. Let's find out. Now, you remember where Jaled Dar's skeleton is. Well, actually, you might not, because that wasn't actually a tour video. That was a lore video, and I just kind of went to where it was. It's in the Plains of Bone, or the Fields of Bone, or whatever this place is called. This place up here. You can just now start to see his skeleton. It's right there where the mouse is. See it there? That's his skeleton. Right there. See the ribs? Not this. I was moving this, but I was actually talking about the leg, but the ribs. Sometimes his shade will rear up and reenact the battle with the Cytherean army. But that's Jaled Dar. By the way, he is effing huge. That's a dragon. Not those little dipshits like Nagafin is like, dude, if I walked into your zone myself, you would be up to my knee. You know, you're a puppy. Get out of here. Don't you talk smack to me. I will slap the shit out of you. This is a dragon. This is what we're talking about. Care for him? Step back. Oh, he's up. Yep. And he's looking nice and happy. He's level 108, epic times 4. I've done this raid 3 times now. Once with Misty, which is impressive as hell considering she's level 95. And twice with Min. The sad part is, well, the one time I actually joined the raid and didn't just go out here solo and start fighting was the one time I just got annihilated because they didn't know what the hell they were doing. Actually, it wasn't so much that. It's just everyone, it was a raid in name only. The healers weren't taking care to heal people and stuff. It was just, it was a mess. We had people running around dragging the ads all over the place, these ads here. Basically, okay, I don't know the story behind this raid. I've talked to him, and this guy just gave me a quest to defeat him, but he didn't really give me any dialogue to go with it. But, from what I gather, the Shade has decided that he's sick of people just ignoring him because he's a non-interactive Shade, and decided he wants to have some fun. So he's going over here to the Giants. Why he's not attacking Rillus, we'll never know, but he's attacking the Giants or something. And they want you to kill him because, yeah, that's what the XR do. They're like, yeah, we can't have that. So you go out here and you fight him, and he just goes rah, 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 and then these little sentry bone golem things come running up and go rah, rah, rah as well. They're obnoxious, but not too terribly tough. But this guy, yeah. He's got some umphy moves on him. He emotes quite a bit. One of the things he'll do is rear back his head to scream. When he does that, brace yourself. You're about to get stunned for a few seconds and take some hefty damage. He also will look behind him. If you're standing behind him when he does that, he'll kick you in the face or something. I'm not quite sure what he does there. Usually I fight him right underneath his belly because, well, as I said, the one time I joined the raid was the time I did the worst. I mean, hell, Misty didn't die the entire time I fought him. She's level 95, he's 108. So, I mean, yeah, he's red to her. He's instant death. In fact, he would not give me the quest. Watch what happens when I talk to this guy. I'm too low a level, so this is what he says. Let's go over here and see what he says. Hey, Herald of Gannic. And he's like, what's up? You would not survive a second against the First Brood, young one. Well, as it happens, Misty survived just under 40 minutes against the First Brood. And, yeah, she got her little treat and everything. It was cool. I made a video of it. I might upload it. I wasn't sure because, honestly, it's not much of a video. It's just kind of like a bunch of particle effects on the screen and a whole lot of lag. That was just stuff. But while we're here, let's go take a look over here at the Field of Bone. Okay, well, you can tell why it's called the Field of Bone. Or can you? Let's go down and look. All right, so here we are. Uh-oh. You stay away from me, vile red wiggler. There are too many of them, but I need to get out there. Let's go over here. Go over there. This is also where you'll find plenty of burn. I remember the badger people. Yeah, there they are, the bone diggers. There is a Sokokar post right over there, by the way. This is Kern's Tower. Notice it's a void anchor. So, yeah. It is both a heroic and a raid zone. Times 2 raid, but still raid zone. Yeah, this is why it's called the field or Plains of Bone or whatever it's called. What is it called? If I could get my mouse on, maybe not. I don't see it. It should say it somewhere around here, but I don't see it. Okay, that's Camp Cromdeck. That's the giant logging camp. I can't quite get my cursor on that. See, because those are interrupting it, but. maybe if I get a little closer. No, it won't. Okay, well, anyways, this place is called, like, the Plains of Bone or the Fields of Bone. The Somethings of Bone, anyway. You can tell why. See? It's not actually because of that. It's because of this. This is where they fought Jaled Dar and got annihilated. Because he was a badass. This is the leader of the Ring of Scale. This is the true leader. This is the founder of the Ring of Scale. This is the badass extraordinaire. Everyone's worried about the prismatic dragon. Oh no, the sleeper has awakened. Oh, I'm so scared. All right, go fuck a worm, dude. This guy, I put my money on him. This guy would kick Caraferm's ass. I don't care what the lore says. This is not official lore. This is my lore. He would eat Caraferm's face. Although I don't think he would because Caraferm's fucking ugly. But anyhow. Enough about Jaled Dar. I've got a thing for Jaled Dar. So let's go take a look at the Burn Eye. You're going to find them over here, the Belly Wumpers. I think they're called the Belly Wumpers. Belly Wumpers? Yeah, Belly Wumpers. So you got the Bone Diggers. These are not friends to the Belly Wumpers. These guys are going around here digging up stuff. And these guys love shinies. These guys love shinies. That's all I can really say about it. So you get this quest up. You can do quests for them too. And yeah, they'll send you out here. They also are very interested in finding out what happened to their lord, Kern's Tower. They have a lord in there or something, and they'll send you in there to find out what's wrong, and that's how you get inside Kern's Tower. Like I said, there's two versions. There's a heroic version, and there's a times two raid version. On this side, you have a little Sokokar. Where is this? There it is. Sokokar post right there. There's also a tiny little canyon over there with it's called an extended hub. There's a few quests that you can get from inside here. But we don't really care about that, do we? No, we don't. Because we just want to take a look at it. Very pretty. Be careful. Around here, if you're a Beast Lord, is one of the critters that you need to fight for your Beast Lord epic. There he is. Yeah, I'm kind of having flashbacks there. Yeah, that's the Agonizer, and he lived up to his name at the time. That was when epics changed. The Beast Lord doesn't get an epic at level 80. They get one at level 90 or 95 or whatever it was. So their epic quest was a lot more substantial than anyone else's epic quest was. And from what I've seen of the Channeler epic quest, the same could be said of that. In fact, they don't get to do epic repercussions because when you get your epic weapon, it's already innervated. You have a nasty-ass raid to get your mythical version, and I can't say at present if this is still the case, but at the time it was, let's just call it, extremely substantial, and only two guilds that I knew of had actually done it. People were charging thousands of plat to get their epic updates, or their mythical update for that fight. And you gotta fight the God of War. You need his power to re-empower the claws. I haven't gotten around to it yet. I don't know if my guild could pull it off since, you know, there's like, you know, three of us. And, well, you're looking at all three of them right now because no one else shows up. But even so, we want to go over here. This is where the rhyme showed up. This was not originally here. This added with the rhyme. Here's where the rhyme showed up. All right, here's the herald of the rhyme. If I could get my mouse to stay on him. There we go. Order of Rhymes. He's got their little frosty armor and stuff, and that's a pretty cold stare he's giving me. All right, so here we got some dragon turtles. Then we got more rhyme over here, and yeah. They're here looking for something. I cannot remember what it was they were looking for. Hey, this guy. Isn't that the guy in the in Kratok's fortress? That might be one of the bosses from Kratok's Fortress. The name is definitely familiar. Anyhow, see they got their little harnessed dragon turtles. It's got that Chinese dragon look to it. It's all like, what up? I'm a Chinese dragon turtle. The Spinebreaker. There's Kratok, that guy probably is the guy from the fortress. This is the leader of Rhyme. He's just some dude. Thought, what up? I'm like, yeah. Actually, let's hail him. See what he does. Hail. Leave my presence! Oh, well, aren't you a friendly asshole? Fine, screw you. See if I share my tank with him. Alright, so since we're also over here, we're going to check out the big ape. There's a giant ape over here. I can't remember what it's called. It's a giant ape, though. Sometimes. It's on one of these islands. It's kind of like the King Kong Island. Remember how King Kong was found on an island? Well, there's a giant ape on one of these islands with like little wormy things that come up out of the ground. Ew. I've seen enough anime to know where that's going. I think it's on that island over there. Could be this one, but I think it's that one. Yeah, this has got the crabs and stuff, so... I can't remember what it's called. The Targan? The Talgan? Well, there was a gorilla over here. It may or may not be up, but we'll go take a look. I don't see him. There's little thingies. Island of the Forgotten Ape. Yeah, this is Godzilla's island. I'm not Godzilla. King Kong's island. See, they got those little thingies. We don't like those little thingies. I don't know if there's anything particularly special about this ape. I don't recall. Actually, no, he did. He did help me play a really funny joke on some of my guildies once. They were all like, "You're not gonna fight him. You're too scared." So I pulled. But what they didn't realize is that I also have a feigned death. And so I pulled and I feigned death. And they had buffs on me, so they had aggro when I pulled. Or I should say they had aggro when I feigned death, because I didn't have aggro anymore. And he walked over there and smashed their faces, and it was pretty funny. We all had a good chuckle, and they told me I was an asshole, and I was like, yeah, I am. That's just how it is. Also, I need to ask, is the microphone volume okay? Someone mentioned that the microphone volume was low, but that was, again, on one of those videos that I had a comment on that I didn't know about from months ago. And I'm using a different studio thing here, and it doesn't have the same volume controls. And honestly, I can't tell how to change it, but it looks like it was set to maximum already. So, yeah, hoping that it's Field of Bone. All right, this is the Field of Bone. So, as I was saying, I was hoping that the volume's okay. If not, let me know. I'll try to figure out something. If there's anything to figure out. Like I said, it looks like they're already set to maximum, but I don't know. The other one had nice, simple, you know, slider controls. Very easy to read, very easy to use. This one, it's just got like a... It looks like an equalizer bar graph, but it doesn't seem to have any way to change the volume itself. It's just telling me how much it's picking up, so... whatever. Alright, there's not much left to see. We got a few more places. We need to check out Rillus. We can also check out the Drogon Exiles. They are goblins. Well, they're mishmash, goblins and giants. They're from Naroga, but they're exiles. So they're good guys, so we can do stuff for them, and they like us. Naroga is another shard zone, and it's up in the hills up here by Cabalus. Cabalus is an ancient Ixar city that's like ruins now. It's, again, up in the mountains. I'll show you there in a moment. Here's the exiles. Check them out. They're into like they're kind of like wannabe gnomes. They're all into gears and techno stuff. So you'll run into technomancers and stuff like that. And but they also have, you know, what the hell's a thaumaturgist? I don't know what a thaumaturgist is. No, a thaumaturgist is, but he's a gear zerk and stuff like that. So yeah, they're all tinkery. They're all tinkery. You can do stuff with these guys. They'll help you. There's also a is this it? Reed. This might be the one. Goblin Revenge. Yeah, Thazolu. Okay. Gives you 10,000 faction if you do it. It's a very easy quest. Out in the Field of Bone, there is one of those Scorpicus guys, and his name is Thazolu, and you just kill him. And then come back here and talk to someone, I don't remember who, and yay. Woohoo. It's an easy quest. You should totally do it. Just do it right now, in fact. You should just stop watching and go do it right now. Because... they'll thank you for it. This is Kiko's favorite spot in the entire game. I mean, of all the zones, when I ask him, what's your favorite zone of the game? He always says, Fens of Nathsar, right by the Exiles of Droga. And I'm like, why? He's like, yeah. Yeah. And he's like, Kiko, you go fucker. Anyhow. So, Naroga, it's down this path here. All right, just go that way, and that's where you'll find the shard zone. I'll go there. Might as well. It's only going to take a minute. We might as well go there. Hey, look, the Ixar Hero is at 13%. That one is different from the Jaled Dar fight. That one, you're trying to stop the statue from reaching the battlement. If it reaches the battlement, then you lose. And they've got, like, ballista set up that you can fire at him, which will drop him to his knees. I'm guessing that's what happens. I saw people shouting about the ballistas. I saw ballistas, and then I saw him drop to his knees. So I'm just putting two and two together. I could be totally off on that. But, yeah. It's a big statue. He walks. You stop him. The end. All right, so here's the Nurgen mining camp. Naroga. That's the shard zone in here. See this little cave up here? Yeah. You'll get lots of quests to go in here if you do the goblin quests. Naroga is off to the side. Is it this one? No? It's off to the side one of them here. This one. This might be it. Yep, this is it. Just looking for that. Behold the lava. Oh my god! And it threw me out. That was kind of cool. Or maybe my finger slipped. I'm not sure. Anyhow, you climb this little ladder thingy here, and Naroga is right there. The Mines of Naroga. So, yeah. There used to be a pain in the ass boss in there, but I don't remember. Which makes me sad because, well, I don't remember. And now if I go in there and find him, I probably still won't remember because I'll just steamroll him. But, yeah, that's a shard zone. Emperor Treeb's Laboratory is another shard zone. And then there's Vexar, the Sunken Theater, I think it was called. That's the final shard zone. It's out in the Lake of Ill Omen. That would be here. That's Vexar. This is the Lake of Ill Omen. This is not an ocean. This is a lake, apparently. But, yeah, Omen's Call is right over here. It's a little human elven encampment thing. Again, it's, you know, just quest hubs. Each faction has a little hub, and they're all like, yay. And they're all existing in an uneasy peace. And by uneasy peace, I could mean that they just haven't gotten around to punching each other in the face, or maybe they just haven't found each other. We don't know, but there's an uneasy peace right now. Hey, look, there's probably another thing that I've already got, but I'm going to try for it anyways. I must. It's a compulsion. Small rhino. Alright, so Cabalus is right over here. This is Cabalus. And this is also where you'll find another Sokokar post. Remember, in the old days, you'd have to go visit each post and then bind your Sokokar to it before you could use that post. You will find a few pages over here, scattered around the area. Notice we got all the ghosts here. So Carpos is just on the other side of this tower. Forsaken Cabalesian Spirit. Yeah. And there's that guy. There's a named one of these guys that roams. There's some of these little guys here. The pages are on either side of the canyon walls. Like, there's a loose page. So this was for the Black Book. And then if you keep going down to there, Cabalus proper, I'm guessing, there is a golem you can kill. Can't remember its name. Oh, wait, over here. Wait, is that right? Yeah. Yeah, that's right, over here. Now, usually there's a golem you can kill right here between them. You need to kill him for something. Just don't ask me what, because I don't remember. Unless I'm completely misremembering, which is a possibility, because that does happen. But, no, I'm pretty sure it was that one, because I do remember fighting stuff on this on my way to kill him. So, yeah, I think... Oh! There it is! Protectus. Remnant of Protectus. Yeah, Sam, he used to spawn right here. Or maybe he has multiple spawn points, but whatever. You can kill him. He's a different looking golem. He's looking more techno. He's like, yeah, I'm a techno golem. Don't mess with me. And then we got these little clay golem dudes. They're just, you know, regular old golems. Alright, now let's finally make our way down to Rillus. Where is that Soko car post? Should be right over there. Come on, mouse, don't do this to me. Ah. Oh, there's the rider, the Northern Lord. Remember him? Yeah, he's a jerk. I remember a bush being there before. That's weird.
Greetings.
Greetings. Take me to Rillus. Gotta love them Ixar. Let's see. Then we got, like I said, there's Omen's Call. Not much to say about that. It's basically a couple of tents, a big building, and then a pier on the seashore below. The building's up on the cliff. We'll take a look at that in a moment. Then there, what we've already seen, Bass's Watch. So yeah, that's pretty much the last one. We've already seen the slave pens. Not much to see there. Okay, one of these buildings, and it might be this one. I think it's this one right here. This, I think, is... Yeah, this is the building. Gotta be careful. Because Ryle... Oh, there he is. There he is, and here's his representative with his snazzy little robes. But I can step into the building and he won't attack me because blind of sight, blocked by the... You know, just remember, our eyes are on our feet or something like that. I don't remember if I covered that or not, but yeah, your eyes are apparently in your feet, so line of sight is drawn from your toes. So, yeah. So that's Dominus Ryle. He's the conspirator of Ick. He's a pretty icky dude. Ha! Ah, yeah, that's right. I went there, buddy. Let's go ask him if he knows where to find some Tang. You know where I can find some Tang? Oh, he's got line of sight. Hey, don't you be attacking my pet. You attack me, dude. Oh, wow. I did some damage there. Actually doing some damage. I mean, yeah, I do have a few levels on him, but still. I got 10 levels on him. Oh, okay, so he's just exactly green to me. Well, we'll fight him. Why not? You guys need some entertainment. This is how we do it in my neighborhood. Die, vile green wiggler. Oh, he spawned a crusader of green mist. I don't know what that means. I'm doing pretty good for someone who doesn't have any form of healing whatsoever. Well, I don't know how to tell you this, dude, but I did challenge you and prevail. But all right. Oops. Looting restrictions. 19 minutes. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah, yeah. Ooh, he dropped a collapsible fishing pole blueprint. He's a fisherman. Wow, I got some cool stuff. That's probably useless to me, but hey. The chest did more damage than he did. All right, so there you see it. I'm a badass. All right. I'm not all talk. I'm just mostly talk. But occasionally, I have a little bit of oomph to back it up. So, yeah. So just as I said, remember, don't get too close because, you know, the angle goes up and then suddenly he's got line of sight again. Or it could also be line of sight extends through the table. I'm not entirely sure how that all works out, but... Oh, another page that I need. All right, let's go check out Omen's Call. I'm almost done with that book. Omen's Call, where you at, buddy?
Well met.
Omen's Call, come on. Actually, wait. Yeah, let's go to the Emperor Tree's Laboratory first. Again, it's just a shard zone. We're not going to step inside, but I'll show you where it is. It's off on the side. This is the birthplace of the Sarnak, as I recall. That's where he made them. He was like, hey, guys. And they were like, hey, what? He was like, I'm going to make a band of super soldiers that are half Ixar and half dragon. And they were like, okay, that's cool. Yeah, no problem. What could possibly go wrong? And then the Ixar were like, oh, yeah, right. Slave revolt. Yeah, we're stupid. In case you're wondering what I'm chomping on a little slice of onion there because my dinner's just sitting here getting kind of cold. See, I sacrifice myself for you. Delicious. I love onions. They're tasty. Very tasty. Alright. Remember how they added Griffin routes, but they didn't actually give them separate routes. They just had them follow. Yeah, it's the same thing with the Soku Carp, so I'm going to be bouncing around for a while because I'm going to Emperor Treeb's laboratory, but I'm not actually going to Emperor Treeb's laboratory. I'm going to Sathir's band, then I'm going over to here, then I'm going to swing by Kmart and see if they got a blue light special going on, then I'm going to go over here to get some pizza from Pizza Hut, then I'm going to go over here and deliver the pizza to a hostel because I'm nice, and then I'm going to come here. Here's Omen's call. There. Building. Dock. Not a lot to see, honestly. But here's Emperor Treeb's laboratory, eventually. It's over here. Built on the cliffside. Secluded. Where he does research and stuff. Behold the glory of Emperor Atreb's laboratory. Yeah. This is the fabled city of Korshaw. Now remember, when you fight Overking, he's in the temple of Korshaw. So, yeah, I don't know what's going on there. Korshaw apparently was a very, very big city. But that shouldn't surprise anyone. I mean, the dwarves did it in Moria. Their thing was like, you know, the size of a mountain range. So, yeah.
Hello.
Hey, how's it going? All right, so... Belly Womper's Pose, like I said, there's Kern's Tower. It's kind of a shard zone-ish, kind of. It's a later shard zone, but whatever. But yeah, that's the fence. Alright, so it connects to Kylong, it connects to Kunzar here and over here somewhere. And yeah. Kylong, Kunzar. There's all this stuff. Oh, we haven't shown you Vexar yet, so yeah. Oops, what am I doing?
Greeting.
Check this out. We will do this. We'll go to Bathus's watch, and then we can just jump off. Because remember, you can always jump off of the mountain. All right. Doing all the quests. We'll take you out to this little island and out into the lake, and you'll do stuff under the water. There's also stuff down there that you'll do. There are some pages along here. The monk epic. There's a guy you need to talk to. He roams this beach, so yeah. Look for him. Alright, that's Vexar right there. That little pokey thing. Spire. It's underwater, so if you can't breathe underwater, you gotta swim for it. You can make it, but better safe than sorry, right? There are things in the lake. I'm not seeing any. I could be too far. Oh, there we go. Shine! That's actually what I was looking for. The Omen Walker. He is a little elemental thing. Rock elemental guy. Called Shine. I don't know if he shines. It doesn't look like he shines to me, but whatever. Maybe he'll shine your shoes if you ask him nicely. I don't know. And then over here you got the Aqua Golems and the Yale. Alright. The Lake Ruins. You'll find a couple pages out here as well. And there's a guy that normally sits around here. No, he's not over here. He's over there. Over there, I do believe. Oh, there he is. Threeko. There's a quest to do something with him. Don't ask me what it was, because now that I think about it, I can't remember exactly what the quest was, but yeah, you'll come out here looking for him. He's he's surrounded by mindbenders. Yeah. The Yale mindbenders and hydromancers, so watch out for that. They do stuff. They'll do, like, mezzes and charms and stuff. I don't remember all the stuff they do, but they do stuff. So I guess these guys aren't goblins after all. These guys are just Yale. I thought they were goblins. No, the goblins are in Vexar. Never mind. Ignore me. The goblins are in Vexar. So, yeah. And then you got some Sarnak from Bathazoo. They're out here. You got these little cockatrices. Kiko loves these guys. I'm not going to tell you why, but I'm sure you can figure it out considering all the things I say about Kiko. And if he doesn't like it, what's he going to do about it? Nothing, because he's not here. Oh, yeah. That's what you get when you disappear without a word, jerk face. Tail paged in. I was going to pick that up. Notice I'm not taking any chances with my music since, you know, I don't know when official music is going to slap me with 50 copyrights or not, so I'm just going to use my own music. Yeah. So, yeah, that was the Fens of Nathsar. So, remember there's a public quest up in the Field of Bone where you fight Jaled Dar. We got a raid zone down at the bottom of that ravine down there, Tumathuga. Got a couple of different shard zones. There's the Mines of Naroga, there's Vexar, there's Emperor Tree's Laboratory, and of course there's Kern's Tower, which is a shard / raid zone. I've done the shard zone, not too difficult. Couldn't speak for the raid zone. I was working on it with a group for a while, but they gave up relatively quickly after just a couple of wipes. I do remember there was like these giant plasma laser beam things that you had to watch out for in the environment, but other than that, I don't remember much. So, yeah. Anyways, I will catch you next time, so peace out. And like I said with the comments, if I don't answer a comment, either you sent me a comment that looks suspiciously like spam, like, hey, please follow me on Instagram. No, thank you. Or I just didn't see your comment because YouTube didn't tell me about it. So if you really want to get a message to me, send me a direct message. It does tend to notify me of those. So peace out, and catch you next time.